You've heard it time and time again. Calls for peace in the wake of gun violence. But tonight, after the deaths of two more young men, a call for the city to find a solution. Good evening. I'm Rob McCartney.
I'm Melissa Frying for Brandi Peterson. Multiple vigils tonight for murder victims, both of them teenagers.
A 14-year-old boy shot to death in an alley Saturday night. And DeJean Johnson, a father of two, ambushed as he walked past a church in the middle of the day.
Tonight's big story, what does it take to replace the anger and keep our young people alive? KTV News Watch 7's Jeremy Maskell is live.
Melissa, tonight's prayers brought dozens of different people together from across Omaha and from different faiths. But everyone agrees it needs to be bigger to combat the continuing problem taking too many young lives.
You are at work in this neighborhood.
In the light of day, a push against darkness.
This is totally unacceptable.
These people pray for peace where a shooter killed Etienne Burns, while some search for hope. Stand on the corner of 30th and Ames and see determination to change this story.
There's no reason for it.
Countless groups working every day to change lives. Groups like the Empowerment Network.
Reach out to us, reach out to Impact One, reach out to other organizations, reach out to the churches.
Despite all that, travel just 20 blocks west to where someone shot DeJean Johnson, and you hear a disconnect.
This ain't the first friend that I lost around me.
Talking to people like Apollo Cobb.
They come for one day, about 2 days later, you'll never see them checking back on their mom or the family. So I believe in a support system, but do it work after this?
He says there needs to be more, building better relationships, lasting longer, turning individual success into community change.
I'm losing all my homies and everything, so I think I need to stop.
A call many want to answer, to inspire a brighter future.
Especially when you lose a teenager, someone that's just beginning to start their life. There's no reason for it.
And that is the real challenge here. Those resources, those groups say they are ready to help, but they need people to pick up a phone instead of picking up a gun. The Empowerment Network says this is a problem everyone across the community can help solve. We've posted links to ways they say you can help on our website. Just check the As Seen on 7 section of KETV.com. Reporting live downtown, Jeremy Maskell, KETV News Watch 7.